So you're finally getting around to beating Dory's kids at last.
Are you going to get married?
Dory, why don't you take the first crack at this?
Christine and I are good friends.
So what is that? Another way to say you're living together?
Kids, they like me.
Guns like a magnet to a kid, doesn't matter where you hide it.
I'm not about to hide it. I'm a police officer, and I am required to have a gun.
So what do you have to say now, Rivera? Still think my mother's a meter maid?
Come on, Lacey.
Bobby, put that gun down.
So I slept very restless, and twice I went down the road away in the night and slipped around the front.
What is this? What is that word?
Road.
Road.
And slipped around the front and see her sitting there by her candle in the window with her eyes toward the road and then tears in them. And I wished I could do something for her, but I couldn't, only to swear that I wouldn't never do nothing to grieve her anymore.
Michael, wait till I cool off. You get a bellyache.
You always say hot cookies give you a bellyache. How come?
Because that's what my mother used to say to me.
She hides in different places, but I can always find it. I've got a dollar on this one. Kiss a goodbye, Rivera.
Look at that book. Remember last year? You couldn't even read a book like that. You work very hard. Are you proud of yourself? I'm proud of you, too. Give me a bite.
No.
Why not?
They're hot. You'll get a bellyache.
Oh, very smart, Michael. Bring me more.
I know it's here somewhere. Hey, Rob, help me out here.
Tom Sawyer on a mattress, and that old doctor and Jim. Enter Calico.
Let me see. And Jim in her calico dress.
Calico. What does calico mean?
Go get the dictionary.
It's on Harvard's bookshelf. I can't reach it.
Oh, you are full of baloney. You just wanted a little time here with these cookies.
What'd you bake them for?
For after dinner. I'll get it. One more, you hear me, mister?
Freeze! Wow. Can I hold it? One more step and you've had it.
Come on, Lacey, let me see the gun.
So what do you have to say now, Rivera? Still think my mother's a meter maid?
Come on, Lacey.
Say it.
Harvey! Put that gun down. I'm not fooling around here. Now put it down. Put it on the bed. Don't. Robert, I think you should go home now.
We were just fooling around.
Robert, please go home.
You were told never to touch this gun.
I just wanted to show Robert.
You never, never point a gun.
It was unloaded. You always are.
Loaded or unloaded, you never point a gun. You have any idea what might have happened if there'd been an accident?
Okay, I get the point.
Don't you smart mouth me. I trusted you to stay away from that gun. You're 14 years old. You know better. You have disobeyed me because you want to look like a big deal, and you could have blown your friend's head off. Are you hearing me?
Yes, I hear you.
Go to your room.
You.
Looking for a guy named Ulis.
Ulis?
Ulis, right.
Ulis.
Sam Ulis.
Sam. Ulis. Like Lieutenant Sam Ulis?
Right,
follow me.
If I have to stake out one more bathroom, I mean, I feel like I've been in every men's room on Wall Street.
We'll get him sooner or later, Victor.
Oh, yeah? How are you gonna get him? For 2 weeks, we've been lurking in bathroom stalls. I'm getting to feel like I'm some sort of pervert.
Dory?
Enjoy it, Victor.
I would like to meet your children.
Dress up like Wall Street executives. It's just part of the job.
What do you mean, make plans? Well, you're the one who's always talking about being so spontaneous. No, I am not complaining. I have to get back to work, too. Good luck on the Sierra collar. Boy 10, girl 14.
That's nice.
Uh-huh.
So you're finally getting around to beating Dory's kids at last.
Uh-huh.
That's nice.
Mary Beth, that is not Dory's fault.
I didn't say anything.
Yes, you did. He has an ex-wife. He has an ex-wife he has to contend with, and he doesn't get to see the children as often as he'd like to.
Who's catching?
We are, sir.
Been a shooting at 2209 Lexington Avenue. Uniforms on the scene, asking detective to respond.
Got it. Yes, sir.
2209 Lex.
Got it.
See that? A shooting. Probably a homicide.
Homicide, yeah.
Hey, I need your attention because we got to move fast. All right, Team A, door to door. Team B, plates. Team C, you lucky guys.
You got it. Receptacles, huh? Look, if he ditched it, we want to find it before a citizen does. Thank you.
You men of the 22nd, thank you very much for helping out.
And he owed us.
Victor, play nice.
If you do recall hearing anything at all, if anything comes to mind, would you please call us at the 14th? Why, thank you.
Nothing. Nobody heard nothing, no tenant reported gunshots.
You'll love it. Walls in this building must be 6 feet thick. They sure don't make them like this anymore.
Oh, come on.
Let's walk it.
From bathrooms to trash cans.
You're taking this personally, Victor.
I can't help it. Did you notice anyone in the 22nd in Team C? You know, I mean, we could have drawn vehicles. We could have drawn door to door. Instead, we drew garbage.
Well, it takes a trained detective to sift through garbage for evidence, Victor.
Right. It's a dirty job, Victor, but somebody's got to do it.
How many more after this?
Two.
Oh, Lord.
You know what's weird? How many yellow sheets have you seen on cat burglars who carry weapons? They don't want that kind of trouble. They don't want to get arrested with weapons on them. I'm telling you, listen to me, Rivette, I'm serious.
The other day I was on 34th Street. They had a sale on support holes. Slow down.
Listen, a cat burglar who climbs in and out of a window. He doesn't disturb so much as a saucer. What reason would he have to gun down a 65-year-old man?
You know, Christine, I had them in my hand.
What?
Support holes. I was the next in line at the counter, and I couldn't do it.
Cagney, Lacey, are you on the air?
Yeah, we're here, Petrie.
We got something.
Good police work, huh? Bread and butter. Nitty-gritty work. That's what it's all about, isn't it?
That's right, Victor.
Did you and your husband keep a gun in the apartment?
No.
Was it unusual for him to be here during the day?
I lost him.
Hide it in 50 different places, he's still going to find it.
I unload the thing every night, Hog. I put it different places, and...
Gun's like a magnet to a kid. Doesn't matter where you hide it.
It's not about hide it. I'm a police officer, and I am required to have a gun.
I know. Stupid kid. We'll think of something. We got a problem here. Boys don't know about guns, not really. You see guns on TV everywhere. Boom, boom, hero gets wounded. Next day, he's up and around. They see their own mother carry a gun.
Oh, that's our kids. I told them, from before they could walk, I told them time and time again, it's not a toy. I don't know what else I can do.
There were no external injuries noted, period. The temporal muscles reveal no hemorrhage, period. Sorry, girls. Didn't mean to keep you waiting so long. Oh, it's been a very hectic morning.
It's all right. We called about the Barron case. Harry Barron?
Barron, yes. Harry Barron. 45 caliber bullet entered the right side, rupturing the spleen and passing through the left lobe of the liver. And after a page and a half of catastrophic internal damage finally lodged against the lumbar spine. A pretty routine gunshot trauma if it weren't for two things.
Want to let us in on it?
I'm sorry. It's not often I get a chance to look into someone's face and see anticipation. There seems to be an incongruity about the pattern of powder traces on the man's right hand. And the preliminary report says Mr. Barron was shot at close range by an assailant. But the powder traces on the victim indicates that he was holding the gun, not simply grappling for it.
You said there were two things.
Blood stains on the carpet reveal two types of blood.
The shooter was hit.
Either that or he got a very nasty cut shaving.
Lieutenant? Yeah. Oh, is that new, sir?
Yeah, I treated myself. No more cold pastrami sandwiches.
They are wonderful. Harv and I got a bunch of brochures. We read them all the time.
Yes, do you know how to turn this thing on?
It's electronic, sir. Oh, it's beautiful. You program it by touching a panel right. I know where it is, right there. Yeah.
Well, I got the report from motor vehicles. Your canvas didn't turn up any stolen cars. What about emergency rooms and the cabbies?
Well, we don't have any leads yet, Lieutenant, but I know someone must have seen him. Apparently, he lost a lot of blood, so he's going to have to go...
Oh, no, you can't do that, son. No.
Do what?
Put foil in the microwave, sir. It sparks up. Mm-hmm. Yeah, you have to take off that wrapper. Put it in without the wrapper. It says so in all the brochures.
Anyway, we got a match on the 45 that is Becky picked out of the trash.
You did?
Oh, no, it'll be
Lieutenant,
perfect,
you
sir.
Got a match?
Yes, sir. It'll take less than a minute.
What?
Hello?
Put
it in here.
Yeah?
You got a match?
Well, last year there was a shipment of 75 guns stolen from the National Guard Armory. What'd you say, 1 minute?
1 minute.
Yes?
And the serial number of the gun that was used in the Barron homicide, well, that identifies itself as one of the stolen guns from the 75.
Wait a minute. Lieutenant, you're not going to turn this over to the Major K Squad.
Yeah, well, it may have to go back to the 16th on account of they had the original 61, you see. Detectives Gomez and Locarto, they've been following the gun heist now for about 11 months. What I don't understand here, Lacey,
that
is
isn't right.
Why, if the tinfoil is going to spark and burn, why wouldn't
that be right? That's right. Plastic wrap, like that, plastic? That'll work.
Hey, enough about the oven! Excuse me, Lieutenant, but I mean, this is not the first time this has happened with the 16th. Remember the Zemanski extortion case? We did all the legwork. They got the collar.
Will you hold your horses, Cagney? You know, this works two ways. One day, they're going to do all the legwork, and you'll get the glory.
Sure. First felony jaywalking collar in history.
You know, sir, that homicide collar really is ours, sir.
First of all, I don't see any collars, all right? What you got to do is get all your facts together and then get an arrest warrant, and then maybe we'll have something to talk about whose collar it is. Right?
Right, sir. That should ding pretty soon.
Yeah, like you said, in 1 minute, huh?
Did it work?
Oh!
Is that fantastic?
That's a hot pastrami.
You should close that door back up, sir.
Yeah, okay.
Enjoy it.
Oh, they put pickles in here. It's hot pickles.
You dropped a sock.
Thanks. You see my running shoes?
Under the bed. Don't forget your dental floss. And your baby oil. Dory, this is really ridiculous.
It's easy this way.
You know, I'm very curious. How are you planning on introducing me?
Well, Christine Cagney, my friend. We are friends. Aren't you my friend?
You know, they're not going to shrivel up and die if they find out we're living together.
Chris, I have my own apartment. I really don't live here.
Well, you could have fooled me. You've been here every night for the last 2 months.
I'm not going to cause my kids any unnecessary confusion.
What confusion? You've been divorced 5 years.
Oh, Chris, it's not that simple. Your role in my life should be carefully explained slowly and in phases.
I feel like I'm being introduced to your parents. Dory, we're not kids.
Yeah, but my kids are.
But it's your problem, not your kids.
Chris, just let me handle this, okay? Let me handle this my way.
Forgot your robe.
A lot of people think because you're looking through the front windshield, you don't know what's going on in the back of the cab. Let me tell you something. I got eyes back here. Yeah. See, I can see everything that's going on in the cab.
Could you tell how badly he was hurt, Mr. King?
Well, I'll tell you, his arm was out of commission because he had to reach over with his other arm to shut the cab door.
Which arm was that?
You see, I pledge allegiance to the... It was his left arm. Because, you know, he was sweating hard. He was breathing heavy, you know? So I says, hey, buddy, you all right, you know? So he says, he gives me this line of garbage. I got knifed in a barroom fight. You should have seen the other guy. That's a lot of baloney, right?
Well, we don't know Mr. King, but we're gonna find out.
Yeah, well, you know, I was right. I knew it then. He was lying. You know, you get a sixth sense after a while. I can tell you, if a guy's sitting in the back of my cab, whether or not he cheats on his wife.
You're kidding.
No, it's square business.
And your trip ticket here, it says you dropped him at Lexington Hospital 4:38 p.m.
Yeah, I offered to walk him in, you know, get him a wheelchair. And the guy got annoyed. So I figured, hey, what am I, social worker now? I said, you know, let him go.
Basic phone.
So do you have a description? Excuse me.
Yeah, he was about 5'10", 6 feet.
Detective Lacey, 14th Squad.
You know, kind of a hard
face.
Oh,
hi, honey. Yeah.
Not a bad looking guy.
I'm in the middle of something right now. Did you get a chance to talk to him?
Lean, not Bobby De Niro, but, you know, like that, you know what I mean?
De Niro.
Yeah, like...
Lean.
Yeah, like his essence, you know, like his hair was, like, straight. I mean, if you saw him, like, far away, you...
I'll call you right back.
Way far off.
When you see him close, you know.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
We agreed, Harv. You let his coach stew.
And he wants to go to
he comes directly home from school. He does his homework. No TV, no telephone, no going out, no nothing.
A professional cat burglar should know if he checks into an ER with a gunshot wound, he's going to have to answer some questions.
So where'd he go from here? He could have got another cab, but no other cab came forward.
Either did the transit authority. You think he walked? He's cold. He's wounded.
No, he did not fall. But there's a bunch of transient hotels a couple blocks between here and the river. Now, say our guy has a record. And say he was paroled into this area.
So we check it out.
Oh, my feet are killing me.
You probably should have bought those support hose, Mary Beth.
Oh, that's funny, Christine. You're a laugh a minute.
It's where they pay me the big bucks. Oh, 3, 2. Well, it looks like a 1. If you don't reach me, it's a 7. No, Jerry, I said 7th and West 11th. All cat burglars on parole in this area. Yeah, I'll wait. Okay, thanks, Chair. Bye.
Let me guess, the computer's down again.
10 minutes. Modern science, when it works. Boy, you didn't get sodas?
I only got 2 hands. Let's catch them.
You think Vilmar Sala's pushing it a little?
The boy is 10, right? Yeah. Hamburgers, french fries, glass of milk. He's not gonna taste anything. It's like a steam shovel. And the girl is what?
14.
14.
Probably on a diet. Well, it's 1 shrimp and a piece of lettuce and a little cocktail sauce. Isn't anorexia kind of in teenagers today?
Oh, where I came from, anorexia was when you were less than 10 pounds overweight.
Great. 2 colas.
If Dory pretends he can't find his way to the bathroom, my eyes are gonna cross. You can't believe how nervous he's been. And you're not.
Do I look nervous? Just because I'm the new woman in their father's life? Thank you.
Thank you.
Just because if they don't like me, maybe he'll decide he doesn't like me either. Why should I be nervous?
Well, you not make a big deal, Christine. It's only dinner. You'll get to know each other, meet each other. I'm sure it'll be very nice.
I want it to go well, Mary Beth. I really do. I want him to like me. I mean, kids like me, don't they?
Yeah.
Michael? Harvey Jr.?
Harvey Jr. has a major crush on you. You're right up there with that mermaid girl. What's her name? Daryl, what's her name? Gee, I'm worried about him.
Oh, Mary Beth, I've never dated him younger than 30.
No.
All right, 25 tops.
I'm talking about the gun thing, Christine.
Excuse me, lady, I'm waiting for a call here.
Tough, I'm making a call.
It's official police business.
Yeah, and I'm J. Edgar Hoover. Tell him to hurry up, will you?
Get off the phone!
Why don't you take this?
Watch the mouth, kid. Your hair will turn brown. Kids, they like me. Cagney? Mister?
Want to get lost?
Are you in there?
Open up, Mr. Gorby. It's the police. Freeze! Hold it right there. Come here. Come on.
I'll get an ambulance.
It's all right, Mr. Gorby.
It's
all right. We'll get you help.
Why should I lie, huh? I know the law.
Somebody dies during a felony, doesn't matter whose gun it is, it's murder, right? But it wasn't mine. Look, hey, come on. I've been picked up lots of times, okay? But I've never done heavy time. I'm gonna have one good arm, they're gonna send me up to Attica. What chance am I gonna have up there? Why would I carry a gun? I don't like guns.
So whose was it? Mr. Gorby, a judge is gonna be looking at all the facts, including your cooperation. Where'd the gun come from?
There were only two of us in the apartment. Me and the old man, so you figure it out.
We're here to see Mrs. Barron.
I'm sorry, but she's unavailable.
Well, we called a half hour ago. She was available then. I believe she's expecting us.
Well, that's why I'm here. I'm Mrs. Barron's attorney, Stuart Harrigan.
Mr. Harrigan, that's like in that song, right? We have reason to believe that Mr. Barron was shot with an illegally owned handgun, sir.
And?
And if the Barrons owned the gun, then we want to know where it came from.
Do you have a warrant?
Do we need one?
I've advised my client not to speak with you.
Well, fine. Would you rather we hauled her downtown and questioned her?
Fine. Go ahead. Then you can explain to your lieutenant why all that effort was expended just to hear the Fifth Amendment recited.
What do you want, Mr. Harrigan?
Immunity from prosecution and from any and all charges stemming from possession of the weapon. Good day.
The woman loses her husband. She's got a lawyer there advising her about immunity papers. You love that? Samuels is going to be thrilled. He hates immunity papers.
Yeah.
What's the matter?
Nothing.
Mary Beth.
I don't know how to get him to take this gun thing seriously.
Take him out on a range. Teach him correct procedure.
No, that's not the answer.
What is? You're a police officer. You gotta keep a gun at home.
I want him to understand about guns. I also want him to never go near one again as long as he lives.
There's nothing wrong with guns, Mary Beth, if you have respect for them and you know how to use them properly.
They have one purpose, to kill people.
That is exactly my point. But you take guns out of the hands of decent people.
And only the crooks will have guns, yeah. I heard it all before, Christine, and I'm not buying.
Okay. New York happens to have the toughest gun control laws in this country.
I'm not talking about laws. I'm talking about my kid. He's so angry at me, Chrissy. I can see it every time he looks at me. He doesn't understand how come I'm making a big thing. And I have to get through to him because he has to know it's not the movies here. When you're dead, you're dead. You never get up again.
Okay, I talk. You listen. Your mother thinks she can't talk to you. She's very angry and hurt. You did a very stupid thing.
I was just messing around.
Harvey, you mess around with booze, cigarettes, maybe we talk about it. You mess around with guns, we do not discuss it. There is no room for argument here.
Why is she making such a big deal about it?
Your mother is a cop. She knows more about guns than you and I are ever gonna know. She comes home sometimes sick to her stomach because she saw some kid that day with his guts splattered all over the pavement. So then she sees her own kid pointing a gun at someone. What do you expect her to do? Harvey, you're not a kid anymore. You're 14 years old. In a couple of years, you're gonna be a man. A gun doesn't make you a man. Being honorable makes you a man. And what you did wasn't honorable. You understand what I'm saying?
Sure.
Look at me. You understand me?
Dad, I got some homework to do.
Mm.
What's so funny?
It's the mother's sister. We always went there on holidays, and...
You kind of had to be there.
I have sort of a weird family, too. I have an Uncle Willie, who, every time he has too many beers, he thinks that his wife is from outer space. I guess you'd have to know my aunt.
I don't see any salt on the table.
Oh, I'll get it.
Thank you.
Where do you keep it, Chris?
With the pepper. In the cupboard over the stove.
Oh.
So, Sherry, what, are you in the 9th grade?
10th.
Damn. Do you know where you want to go to college yet?
I don't know. Somewhere in the city.
Sherry doesn't want to leave her boyfriend.
Well, I went to Barnard. You might look into that. It's a good school.
What boyfriend?
Oh, he's just a friend, Dad. He goes to Hunter.
Your mother's letting you date, huh?
Sometimes.
How long have you been dating him?
Since the summer. How long have you been seeing my dad?
Well, essentially, a few months.
Do you love him?
I care for him very much.
So what does that mean? Are you going to get married?
Hey, kiddo, your questions are getting kind of personal, huh?
She asked me personal questions.
Dory, why don't you take the first crack at this?
Christine and I are good friends.
So what is that? Another way to say you're living together? Oh, come on. Your clone is in the medicine cabinet.
Not that it's important, but what were you doing in the medicine cabinet?
I was looking for an aspirin.
Yeah, well, honey, next time, why don't you ask?
Why don't she answer my questions?
Look, Sherry, this is not the time. That's not the place.
What happens to us if you get married?
Yeah.
Now listen, both of you. You're the two most important people in my life, and don't ever forget it. Ever. Okay?
I'll get the hamburgers.
So?
The hamburgers were a big hit.
Yeah?
She raised them as vegetarians.
Well, how was I supposed to know that?
I'm telling you, Mary Beth, I had an easier time on the witness stand of the DeLuco trial. Those kids grilled me. And I'm telling you, she's using them to hold on to Dory. She wants them back, and I know it.
How do you know that?
Because everything he's ever told me about her indicates she's a very demanding woman.
Yeah, she wanted them off cocaine and back in the house with her kids.
She doesn't understand him. She never did understand him. It takes a cop to know another cop.
Is that right? Would you remind me to tell that to Hob?
Hob is different.
Oh, come on, Christine. The kids are basically okay kids, is that right?
Yeah.
So? You have to give her some credit. If the kids aren't screwed up, she can't be all bad. It's not easy being somebody's mother these days.
So I understand. How is Harvey Jr.?
Oh, gee.
Mary Beth, I'm sorry I didn't mean that.
Ah, it's all right, forget it.
I just don't like being one-upped in an area where I'm one-upped.
Forget it, huh?
It's all right.
Mrs. Barron, we believe that you and your husband owned the gun that was used in the robbery.
There had been burglaries all over the neighborhood. My next-door neighbor was robbed twice in a month. I couldn't sleep at night. I'd hear noises and I'd jump. I thought if we owned a gun, we could protect ourselves. It was my fault. I urged my husband to get a gun.
Who sold you the gun?
We tried to get one legally. My husband applied for a permit, but he was denied. They told us he didn't have a good enough reason to own a gun.
Mrs. Barron, we need to know where you got that gun.
Ruth, you have immunity. Don't worry.
Won't I get this person in trouble?
Mrs. Barron, the person that sold your husband that gun did not do you a service. Now, if he has more guns to sell, we want to stop him.
I was terribly upset the last time they turned us down from the Pistol Bureau. I had opened the mail while the postman was sorting through his mail. He saw how upset I was. He said he could help me. A few days later, he sold me a gun. I bought that gun. I wish to God I had never seen that gun.
It may not be fair, but there's nothing more to say about this. The case originated in the 16th.
So where were Gomez and Lucorta when we put this thing together? We tracked down the postman. We placed him in the same National Guard unit as the stolen guns.
We even got the records to show he was doing his reserve duty the same week the guns were stolen, sir.
We deserve the collar.
Yeah, maybe you do, but the collar is going to the 16th. However, I did put in a phone call, and Lucorta and Gomez have agreed to allow you two to assist.
Isn't that great?
Look at. You want to see this thing through or not? Because if you do, you got to make a decision right now, because they are rolling right away.
Yes, sir. Right away. Assist. Let him assist this.
Adrenaline. I remember what it used to feel like.
Petrie, 14.
Yeah, Cagney?
Not now, Petrie.
She says it's an emergency. It's a Mrs. McKenna. Line 2.
Thank you, Petrie. This is Christine Cagney. This is Christine Cagney. Mm-hmm. Well, I'm kind of a rush now. What can I do for you? What's wrong? Is she going to be all right? Did you call the precinct? Yeah, look, let me see if I can track him down for you. What hospital are you at? All right, no, you're very welcome. What? Dory's kid's in the hospital. She's got acute appendicitis and they can't find him.
Oh, Lord. Do you know where he is?
No, but I can track him down. I know some of his street people.
But what are you waiting for? Go and get the lieutenant to clear it.
Well, I got a job, too.
What is assisting an arrest, Christine? This is family here. Dory is family. All right, so you eat a little crow. Would you go ahead and go?
Yeah.
Pay for you. Victor?
Thought you'd never ask.
McKenna?
Yes.
I'm Chris Cagney.
Hello.
Sherry.
She's in recovery. Everything went fine.
I got a hold of Dory. He's on his way.
Thank you very much. I must have sounded like I was coming unglued on the phone. I really panicked. I'm used to colds and fever and chicken pox. This threw me. We've been up most of the night.
You have nice children.
They told me all about your making dinner for them. That was nice.
Sorry, I didn't know that they don't eat meat.
Oh, well, that changes from moment to moment. Depends upon what the best friends are doing at the time. Hope Sherry wasn't too hard on you. I have to forgive him. Divorce has been hard on him. It's real hard for the kids to realize that it's the right thing in the long run.
You know, it's real important to Dory that they know that he loves them no matter what.
Yeah, well, he's making time for him now. Dory's come a long way. You've been good for him.
Well, I'd like to take the credit, Mrs. McKenna, but I think Dory worked very hard to get where he is.
Well, take some of the credit, Chris. Somehow you were there for him. And I appreciate it.
Radiology, please call 356. Radiology, please call 356.
She's all right.
What happened?
She woke up in the middle of the night with terrible pain. I brought her here. They diagnosed it right away as appendicitis.
Are you all right?
Yeah.
Chris, you didn't have to come.
Well, I wanted to be sure that she was all right.
Mrs. McKenna.
Yes?
Sherry's been moved into her room. You and your family can go in and see her now.
Yeah. Make up love.
Chris. Thank you.
Sure. Go see your daughter.
Say hello.
Hi.
Hi.
Come on, Slater.
Gomez and Locorto had the entire block cordoned off. Uh-huh. Attack team was in position. Snipers, canisters, shotguns, bulletproof vests. I mean, we are talking D-Day here, right?
Right, right.
We are all ready to rush. Mm-hmm. Locorto gets on the bullhorn, mm-hmm. orders the guy out. The door opens a crack. Mm-hmm. Now, we all know this is it.
Yeah.
5'3", skinny and shaking like a leaf. And you won't believe the kicker.
What?
Right? Some arms dealer, huh? No guns in the house.
Oh, no.
He's got him in some abandoned garage. He's worried that his kids might get a hold of him.
That's great.
You believe that?
That's great.
Oh, Sherry's okay. They did an appendectomy on her.
Dory's wife, did you meet her?
Well, it's... I don't want to talk about it. Besides, it's time to go home. It's complicated.
Okay, that's it. Conference time, come on.
I guess there's no reason why we couldn't talk about it right here.
She's a very nice lady.
Mrs. McKenna.
Very.
Well, you can say one thing for Dory. He's got good taste in women.
That's family there, Mary Beth.
So is there something that says you can't be a part of it?
I can't be a mother to those children. I shouldn't be. They have a mother. A very good one, I think.
So don't be their mother. Be their friend.
Want to go to Muldoon's? I'll buy. We could have a drink.
I can't. I want to. Can we do it tomorrow? Because I have a date.
You got a date?
Yeah, good looking, huh? Punctual, too.
Hiya, handsome.
I don't get no kisses anymore. Thank you.
So where are you guys going?
Out. I'll see you tomorrow, okay?
Black male, approximately 60 inches in height and 113 pounds, period. The bullet entered the left middle thorax between the 9th and 10th ribs, comma, both of which are fractured with numerous fragments lodged in the surrounding muscle tissue, period. The entrance wound is approximately 2 centimeters in its maximal, period. The bullet traveled downward at a 45-degree angle, comma, rupturing the spleen and left kidney, comma, tearing the abdominal aorta and bruising the ascending colon and right kidney, period. There is extensive hemorrhage within the thorax and abdominal cavity, period. There is no exit wound, period. Musculoskeletal system, colon. The bony framework is well developed and well retained, semicolon. No evidence of fracture, comma. The bullet is lodged in the right iliac crest, which also displays multiple fracture lines, period.